So let's find out what the challenge is. What is the goal of opportunity framing? The goal is to add value to the project. For instance, adding scope such as solar energy, using new technologies, or increasing sustainability. Let's start with an example from real life. The project I'd like to discuss with you is the highway A2 in the city of Maastricht in the Netherlands. The city suffered from the busy highway A2, characterized by congestions, which also creates unacceptable levels of air pollution. It also divided the city into two parts. This situation was already there for decades, but they didn't succeed in making feasible plans. A tunnel was too costly. Plans to move the highway outside the city were not feasible because it would cross a valuable nature area. What to do? 15 years ago, the project was reframed. The opportunity was to look at the project in a new way, a broader way. From an infrastructure project, it became a city development project. Yes, this includes a tunnel. But the opportunity was, by bringing the highway in a tunnel, the new space that is created by bringing the highway underground could be developed in two directions. First, real estate and apartments. City development contributes financially to the infrastructure. And second, an environmental upgrade of the area. A major part of the new space will be designed as a green zone that has been generating extra support for the project. This project is named after this green zone, the green carpet, and it will heal the city that was divided into two parts. Let us look at the opportunities closer. The contractor came up with the opportunity to build a double-deck tunnel. The upper part is for traffic with the destination city of Maastricht. The lower part is for regional traffic that only wants to cross the city. This creates extra lanes and is much safer. But it is not only a technical infrastructure project. The new area above the tunnel gives the opportunity to integrate this in the green city landscape, as mentioned before. For this, extensive consultation sessions with neighbors and other stakeholders were needed. Can we combine this project with other projects in the area? A first example I'd like to give is to integrate this project in other public transportation projects, such as electrical buses. This electrical matches with the idea of green carpet. The second example is social fairness. Can we have citizens participate in the tunnel project that have difficulties entering the labor market? Can we combine other functions? At Maastricht, real estate and apartment buildings are being developed now. Maybe in future, they will also add solar energy or other opportunities. In the end, the goal is the creation of social value. The challenge is, how much can we increase complexity by adding extra opportunities? At opportunity framing, you look at the current situation. Where are we now? And what is the desired situation? Where do we want to be? When do we consider this project to be a success? What are the opportunities for this? And what are possible solutions? And how do we get here? Which stakeholders can we involve? Let's look in somewhat more detail and begin with the questions why, what, and who. Why? Basically, opportunity framing starts with the reason behind the project. What is the problem the project is trying to solve? And who is involved? And how are we creating value? What uncertainties can we expect? When are we satisfied? What is success? What is the strategic fit? After we understand the desired end product, we can decide how we can get there. How should the plan look like? What actions to take? Once again, we stress the importance of setting goals. For a new building, Are we aiming for just a functional building that serves its purpose? Or is it our ambition to create a landmark, such as the Sagrada Familia in Barcelona? It would mean a significant difference in your costs. Along with setting goals comes the creation of value. Are you focused on the sole project or including the impact on society as well? In this example, the church also attracts tourists to the city of Barcelona. Regardless of the skill and ambition of your project, we should carefully define what is part of the project and what is not. This is what we call scoping. Scoping is not only contains the elements that will be part of the project, but also the elements that will be left aside. Scoping helps in defining the boundaries of the project. In the process of opportunity framing, I mentioned several times the importance of stakeholders. Stakeholders might see opportunities you didn't think of and might have interests that are different from those at hand so far. The process of organizing stakeholder involvement will need considerable consideration of you as a project manager and your team. Who are these stakeholders? What are their interests, attitudes towards the project, their power, and how to engage them? Although opportunity framing starts in the early project phase, it definitely does not end here. It is supposed to be a recurring, iterative process aiming at maximum value creation. The context might ask for reshaping your project along the route. Thorough opportunity framing offers a great starting point for successful project realization. But there is a major pitfall. This pitfall is that project manager converge to the presumed solution too fast. We see too often that solutions are chosen early in the process, thereby excluding the many other options present at that point of time. This is killing for potential enrichment of the project.
This phenomenon is called premature convergence.
At the Highway A2 of Maastricht, for decades the project was seen as a mobility project. This was too narrow. It was only after the city looked at the project in a broader way that the breakthrough could take place. This is why we conclude that opportunity framing can add extra value and support for your project if you are open to it in every phase of your project, especially at the front-end development.